MidAmerican Energy and you, together partnering to change the energy landscape by pioneering money-saving, energy efficiency programs and building a new industry in Iowa, wind energy, all while keeping your rates low. So what's next? We'll keep delivering cost-effective energy efficiency programs while putting money back in your pocket. That's right. You decide how best to spend your savings. That's a partnership good for you, good for the environment, and good for Iowa. Another way we're obsessively, relentlessly at your service.
Here's to everyone who believes in competition and good sportsmanship, who knows it's not about the trophies or the medals, but rather the lessons learned. For those who understand, it's not whether you win or lose, just that you give your best. So go ahead, lace them up, take the field, have fun, and play. For the experience, for the memories, for the love of the game, Shields.
February sales event featuring the Silverado sell down at Schottenkirk Chevy Waukee. Up to $12,500 off. Or 0% for 72 months, up to $6,500 on select new Silverado crew cabs. Up to $11,000 off select new 19 Silverado HD crews. And over $9,000 off select new 19 Silverado 1500 crew LT and RSTs. WaukeeChevy.com. New 19 crews, $16,900. Up to $6,000 off or 0% for 60 plus. Up to $3,000 off new 19 Equinox. Sale ends soon. Schottenkirk Chevy Waukee.
Miss your hometown clothing store? The one that had it all? Everything to get the work done all in one place? G&L Clothing is your hometown Iowa store. Stop in and see us. Or we're only a click or phone call away. Family owned for nearly a century. G&L Clothing. 1801 Ingersoll, Des Moines.
G&L Clothing. Your size, your style.
Mr. Hometown Clothing Store, the one that had it all,
brought to you everything. By TST20.com, your online personal trainer. We are live from Thunderhead Sports Bar and Grill in Ankeny.
From Thunderhead Sports Bar and Grill in Ankeny on Ora Labor, I'm Jimmy Olson with Dart Danielson at CISN.TV this week. And we have got a great show, as we do every week for you. And, of course, we're just a couple weeks away from the state tournament for girls basketball. Speaking of,
yes.
Had a good week this week on CISN.TV.
Yeah, and, well, kind of. There was the weather kind of – you see a lot of activities directors around with grayer hair now because all the – weather stuff that went on, and it makes it, you know, to reschedule and redo that kind of thing. And yeah, we had a really kind of different boys game where if you watch that with Valley hosting Waukee, where it was 6-2 Waukee, then Valley goes on a 19-0 run. They lead at half by, I think it was 14. Come out, Waukee turns up the defense. Valley scores 2 points in the third quarter. Waukee ends up winning it, I think, by a point like they did in the first matchup at Waukee. So it was a little crazy. And then a lot of the games got in. But now the girls are starting, you know, the smaller classes are starting in the tournament trail. The, you know, 5A, 4A, that they'll get onto the tournament trail too. But a lot of those games are postponed and moved around a little bit for that. The boys still have a couple games, I think maybe a couple games left before they hit the tournament trail. All the brackets are up on the girls' side and the boys' side on those. Didn't see anything too out of the ordinary on there. The Girls Association Union, they do a great job of spreading those brackets out so they get the best teams that come down to Wells Fargo. You know, so it's going to be interesting. And then,
and we can help you fill out those brackets a little later when we go through the rankings and how everybody is. And we'll be doing that a little later on CISN.TV.
You aren't advocating betting on high school sports now,
I did not say that at all.
But
I hear that is something in the legislature right now. You never know.
That is being talked on.
I'm only giving the news of what I've been told.
I don't know if high school sports will fit into that, though. I don't think so.
I know some guys in Vegas.
That is a topical thing. And then we have a state tournament going on, actually, the state dual meet, which has been the wrestling over whether the duel, how it should be done and where it should be, has been almost as heavy as on the mat wrestling at times, you know, with you saw teams that weren't wrestling their best wrestlers in the duels to save them for the traditional meet, which is, you know, that still rivals anything, probably girls, boys basketball tournament that there is, with the popularity in that and wrestling, you know, here in the state. But the dual meet is on in Southeast Polk and Waverly. Shell Rock are in the championship for the team duels there. So that's also going on in high school wrestling. So, and it always starts, you know, it's wrestling, then girls basketball, mm-hmm. then boys basketball. And we kind of finish up February and March goes out with a flurry, and then we get into the NCAA tournament stuff and all right. that. So it's, you know, and I don't know about you, but I'd be glad to get rid of February in the snow.
That's right. Well, I know there was a few games that didn't happen this past week, which they're even talking about not even doing makeups on those because it's just too late in the season. There's no way they could get it done. But again, with the girls basketball tournament, you'll be able to catch the action of that on CISN.TV here in a couple weeks. So look for that. So again, if you've not subscribed to our YouTube channel, find that, get it done, and get it subscribed so whenever we go live with it being boys basketball, girls basketball, wrestling, soccer, you'll know whenever we are live.
We'll start with a pregame show at the well, mm-hmm. and then 10 o'clock, the games start off. They're all free. All right. you need is a phone or a device, and you get to watch them. And it is the 100th year of the girls' state basketball tournament. And so that's – I know they got a lot of things planned for that, and I was not there for the first one. You know,
really,
Pete was there for number two. I think he missed the first one, but he was there for number two. You know, and I am old enough to remember when I was in high school they played 6-on-6. Mm-hmm. You know.
So, it's a lot of fun, and we always look forward to it every year when we're able to carry that on CISN.TV. And you can check it out, follow along. So if you're at work, you're not able to get away to come down. It's a great way to kind of follow your favorite team or follow one of your relatives that are going to be in that.
Yeah, or if grandma and grandpa live out of state exactly. or aunts and uncles and, you know, a lot of alumni, you still have that. You never lose that, link you had to high school because it's your first group, you know, and that
exactly
and if you can get down and get to a game, it's a whole experience in itself. You know, if you haven't been there in a while, come down and watch the games live. You can still bring your phone and watch the updates too, you know.
Yep.
So
absolutely,
but, anyway,
absolutely. So looking forward to that, and again, still a lot more to come tonight. CISN.TV this week, we'll have the play of the week, the Lightsmith Media video of the week. That's all happening. The rankings, will be going over those as well. And again, if you've not subscribed to the CISN.TV YouTube channel, you want to do that so you can get those notifications of games that are coming up or any games that you might have missed. You can go back and rewatch those games as well. From Thunderhead Sports Bar and Grill in Ankeny on Oral Labor, for Dar Danielson, I'm Jimmy Olson on CISN.TV.
Hi, I'm Chris from Fireplace Superstore. You may have noticed it's starting to get cold outside, and if you're like a lot of folks, that old fireplace in your house isn't doing you much good. You need to replace that thing with a high-efficient gas fireplace from Heat & Glow. We're going to come in, take your old wood or gas fireplace out. We're going to replace it with a warm, cozy, high-efficient, easy-to-use fireplace from Heat & Glow. It'll be the best thing you ever did to your house. Come see us today.
Great price, great selection, great experience. That's what people expect today. What isn't expected is how hard we work after the sale to keep your business. Hard work, honesty, integrity, discipline, trust, character. These core values are why we grow every year and why we continue to acquire more dealerships. Experience the Schottenkirk way of doing business and come visit our dealership in Indianola.
Moms typically get to make a majority of the healthcare decisions for their family. That can be a lot of pressure, but not for me, because I know the choice is ours. For medical tests like MRIs, x-rays, CAT scans, and of course mammograms, ask your doctor to refer you to Iowa Radiology. They work around our hectic schedules, they're the best at what they do, and they're so great with my family. They truly care, and it shows. Visit iowaradiology.com or call to schedule an appointment. Iowa Radiology, our focus is your good health.
Welcome back to CISN.TV. This week, I'm Jimmy Olson with Flynn Heald with Thunderhead Sports Bar and Grill in Ankeny on Oral Labor. And it's time for the play of the week. Again, if you have a play of the week, you could end up seeing that here. Just share it with us on Facebook or Twitter at CISN.TV, and we can see that. In fact, we have one of those, and this one's at Grandview Christian School that was shared with us.
It's been a couple weeks since we've had one of these to show the people, so we're finally glad to have one. This is going to come from the Grandview Men's Basketball, Grandview Christian School, that is men's basketball team. Let's go ahead and run that. As you can see, the ball's moved down the court, thrown off the backboard, And you can see the handiwork there at the end. We'll go ahead and run that back a couple times for you guys.
I know Flynn first saw this and he goes, what team is this? What school? He was pretty shocked by that.
I was kind of confused what sport it was too. It kind of looks like volleyball for a second.
And again, if you've got a play of the week that you see, be sure to share that with us on Facebook or Twitter at CISN.TV, and you could end up seeing your play of the week right here on CISN.TV this week. Now it's time for the Light Smith Media Video of the Week.
And you know we always got a good video there, so we're going to see the Waukee boys basketball this week coming to you.
Analyzing every scar, asking myself how we got here. Remember, this is who we are. I am not here for revenge. I did not come to make amends. Not here to repent for my sins. I just came here to win. I just came here to end. I just came here to fight. Show you everything you said I couldn't be. I became overnight. This for the blood, this is for the tears. This is for my pain and my plight. Two walked in, but only one of us is walking out of here tonight. I'm a survivor. My life, come on, get stronger. I will arise. I'm a survivor. Fight for my life. Come on, get stronger. I will arise.
That was the Light Smith Media Video of the Week. Again, the Waukee boys basketball team. And before that, we had the Play of the Week. Again, if you have a Play of the Week, be sure to share that with us on social media, Facebook and Twitter at CISN.TV. More still to come on CISN.TV this week. In fact, a little later on, Javier Tool, he's going to be chatting with Wade Lookingbill. You want to check out that. And then we're getting ready right now that Jackie Sapp will be chatting with Lisa Brinkmeyer. All that yet to come on CISN.TV this week. I'm Jimmy Olson for Flynn Heald at Thunderhead Sports Bar and Grill on Oral Labor in Ankeny.
You want to get stronger, faster, healthier. You want more. You want to be part of something bigger than yourself. A place for people of all ages, all walks of life, that provides opportunities for all to succeed. We do that. We're the Y. Build more than muscle. Build a stronger community.
Hi, Ron here, head coach of Westside Auto Pros. When your car's on the injured reserve, you want to get it back in the game as soon as possible. I know that. That's why you need to bring it here to Westside Auto Pros. I have a team of experts that can fix almost every automotive injury, whether it's a fractured joint, a brake, or if your car just got its bell rung, no problem. We can even do a complete physical on your car to make sure it's game ready for the entire season. So bring your car to Westside Auto Pros and we'll get it back in the starting lineup in no time. Hey, you guys are dogging it back here. Let's move it, move it, move it.
Is this guy a contractor who does good work or a contractor who needs work? For a reliable recommendation, trust the Better Business Bureau, protecting consumers for over a century. When you go to BBB.org to check out a business, you'll learn if it's BBB accredited, see its grade on customer service, and read honest, useful reviews from local people. For online recommendations you can trust, start with trust at BBB.org/Iowa.
Lisa Brinkmeyer for A Face Behind the Scene. And tonight we're going to reminisce a little bit here and we're going to talk about 6-on-6. Lisa now works for the Iowa Girls Athletic Union and she's assistant director. She doesn't really do mainly basketball. She does things during tournament time, but she's responsible for golf, volleyball, and soccer. Now, whether she played any of those sports, I don't think they're around in her time.
They were two. I played volleyball and I played golf.
Well, there we go. We're going to talk a little bit about that. Anyway, if you're not familiar with Lisa, I'm sure people that are Drake fans out there would definitely remember her. She played for Drake University. She graduated from Hubbard Radcliffe in 1993. They were the last team to win the 6-on-6 state tournament, which to me is quite an honor because I played 6-on-6. It's a game that is kind of it left a void, would you say?
You know, it did a really good job of attaching generation to generation to generation, because really anybody of any athletic talent could play it.
Right,
you know,
you didn't have to be
a great athlete. You didn't have to be a good basketball player, and you could have a spot on the team. So I think it helped bridge a gap for a lot of generations. And when it ended, I think it made some girls choose, you know, if they could play basketball or not. Obviously, they all could, whether they had the confidence to do it.
And the whole town came out. I mean, if you look at state tournaments, I can remember going, and I'm sure for you, everybody came. It's like the whole town just shut down.
We always joke that the assistant manager at Casey's and the bank vice president had to stay behind, but everybody else loaded up and headed.
Well, here's the reminiscing part. In 1993... Hubbard Radcliffe played Harris Lake Park in the first round. They won 87-76, pretty easy game. Then they went on to play West Central, who was a powerhouse for years and years and years, and they won 71-62. Then the real test was Avoca Shelby Tennant. They only won by 5, 83-78. And then the championship game, they won hands down against Atlantic, 85-66. And I asked Lisa a couple things, because when I looked at, she scored 207 points in four games, so that was an average of about 52 points a game. And I said, well, what's the most that you scored?
I had 65 in one game.
And that was the finals.
That was the semifinal. The second. I think that was the West Central Maynard game.
The second round.
And then the... AHST game, that was overtime. So a lot of people say that was the championship game because it went into overtime and we ended up winning.
Were you picked? Was your team number one? I don't even
know. We were number one going in. I was part of a very athletic class. I mean, there were seven of us that went on and played college sports that I graduated with. So we were good at basketball. We were also state runners up in volleyball. We were state runners up in golf that same year. And we were state qualifiers for softball that year before. So, you know, we were good friends off the court. We were a good basketball player or good athletes on the court. So it did help that we all got along really well, too.
I'm sure, obviously. Well, then the next question I asked her was, were you the last person to shoot the last basket of 6-on-6? She said, no, but I got a great story for you.
Yes. So one of my besties, Jody Jansen Barkema, made the last points. It was the last free throws and the last points of 6-on-6. I didn't even remember this, but this is always her go-to trivia question. She'll go up to people and say, well, you do know who won the last 6-on-6 basketball game. Oh, yeah, you know, Hubbard Radcliffe, of course, you know, everybody knows that. Not always, but then she'll say, well, do you know who scored the last points of 6-on-6? Of course, they don't. And then she shares with them that she was the person that scored the last point. So when you asked me that, I felt like she had contacted you and set me up, because it's great trivia.
And she got her name on tonight, so that's the better
yet. Yes, she sure did.
Does she even have the basketball?
It's in our trophy case. We got the great big tall trophy that they used to present, and we celebrated 25 years last year for our championship, and we went back to Hubbard, and they honored us at halftime of the South Hardin, which is now, that's Hubbard Radcliffe now, South Hardin and South Hamilton basketball game, because South Hamilton have a lot of Hubbard Radcliffe kids that have open enrolled there when Hubbard merged with Eldora New Providence.
And South Hamilton used to have great basketball in the
60s. Sure did. So we were honored. Mr. Heiser, our coach, is living in Hubbard at the Care Center, and he was able to come, and he had his red jacket still that the coaches were awarded when they won the state tournament back then. And so it was just a really neat way for us to reminisce and relive our glory days.
So now, did you start from your freshman year on?
I did. And that was controversial, because my freshman year, Mr. Heiser started three freshmen and three seniors. And I remember before one of our first games, he said, well, I'm just... I'm a little nervous about this. And I thought, well, why? You know, here my class, we'd all been great athletes and started all along, all the way up to that point. And he said, well, I might be hearing back from some people about this. And I said, well, if we win, it shouldn't be a problem. And he said, that's right. If we win, it shouldn't be a problem. And we did win. We won the conference that year and won, I think, almost every year after that.
So there was no question.
No, there weren't any problems.
And he was a smart man to start you guys
he
out.
He was. You know. He coached several of the girls on our team's mothers. So oh, he'd wow. been around quite a while.
And he'd been at Hubbard yep. Radcliffe the whole time?
Yep. He'd wow, been yep, coached awesome. For Hubbard, and then when we merged, Hubbard Radcliffe.
So now, did you play post in high school, or were you an out forward?
Well,
or did you guys not have a true post player?
We were all 5'10", the girls,
oh,
the
so
three of us forwards. So we did. We kind of we called it a little triangle. We had one yep. on the wing, one on the high post, and then we all just rotated. And I mean, the girls I played with were really talented. They, you know, we all were stars, and they anybody could have been a star on any team in any given night. You know, someone would score more than the other.
So did the other two go to college basketball, or was another
one of
sport?
Them did. One went to William Penn okay. to play basketball,
okay.
and then the other one went to play volleyball at Pella okay. at Central.
Okay. What was the biggest transition then from 6-on-6 to when you went to Drake?
Well, a lot of people say, is it conditioning? And that was something, you know, to have to run full court. But the biggest thing for me was learning offenses. Because in our offense, our plays were, you know, dribble down, pass in, pass
right,
back out,
right.
dribble up, pass back. You know, we really had basic plays. And that was just get open because one of us was going to score.
Right.
You know, in college, you had to learn all these different plays and what to do. And
a little more sophisticated.
And we had defense. And everybody on the team wanted to play zone defense because they were used to it. I didn't understand zone defense. So I was always so thrilled when Coach Blue would say, all right, we're playing man-to-man. I'm like, yes. I got to worry about one girl, and I got to be, you know.
Well, you got to make sure
you're with her the whole time.
Weak side help, though, in those
well,
kind of
yes,
things.
Yes, that too. But I mean,
the offensive part, that kind of surprised me.
It was harder
me.
For me. You know, shooting that, you know, right. obviously being the 6-on-6er, you know how to shoot and scoring. And I think that being a 6-on-6 player and having, you know, Lisa Bluter, who grew up in the state, and knowing one of the important 6-on-6, and Jan Jensen, who was yeah. a phenomenal 6-on-6 yeah. player, and Jenny Fitzgerald was also my coach, and she was a North Scott grad, and she was an outstanding basketball player. She played 5-on-5 her later years, but you know she knew the importance and
right.
the game of 6-on-6. Right. And so I think they did a good job of incorporating some of our 6-on-6 mentality and moves into the offense. Like Christy Kinney was a great basketball player, 6-on-6 player for Jefferson.
And you had some really good teams when you put the
yeah.
4 years you played at Drake. So
I think that it was important that the coaches
exactly.
could see that right. talent as 6-on-6 players and
yeah.
work them into their 5-on-5
well,
team.
And you have the offensive skills that lots of times 5-on-5
right.
is overlooked because of, for whatever reasons. I mean, it's really refined in the 6-on-6 game.
There were some phenomenal shooters.
Yes.
And no matter what you are and how you play, if you can shoot the ball, you're going to succeed in the game.
Yep.
And shooting-wise, that's what a lot of us did.
Yep. Well, we'll be back the second segment. We'll talk about being a multi-sport since Lisa was, and we'll be back shortly.
WaukeeChevy.com. February sales event featuring the Silverado sell down at Schottenkirk Chevy Waukee. Up to $12,500 off or 0% for 72 months, up to $6,500 on select new Silverado crew cabs. Up to $11,000 off select new 19 Silverado HD crews. And over $9,000 off select new 19 Silverado 1500 crew LT and RSTs. WaukeeChevy.com. New 19 crews, $16,900. Up to $6,000 off or 0% for 60 plus. Up to $3,000 off new 19 Equinox. Sale ends soon. Schottenkirk Chevy Waukee. WaukeeChevy.com.
Here's to everyone who believes in competition and good sportsmanship, who knows it's not about the trophies or the medals, but rather the lessons learned. For those who understand, it's not whether you win or lose, just that you give your best. So go ahead, lace them up, take the field, have fun, and play. For the experience, for the memories, for the love of the game. Shields.
We're back with Lisa Brinkmeyer, and we're going to talk a little bit about multi-sport. Before we talk about that, who was your idol growing up as a 6-on-6 player?
Well, you know, I heard a lot about Lynn Lorenzen from Ventura, just, you know, being the era she was. Denise Long grew up not far from my hometown
right.
in New Providence. Or she was a Union Witten, and, you know, that's not very far from Hubbard. So I knew that name. I mean, probably my biggest idol was my brother. He's 3 years older than me. and we played countless hours in the driveway, and he beat me down and blocked my shots. And
he made you who you were.
And he made me who I was. So I have to probably give him the biggest credit.
Did he go on to play
back? He did. He went to Wartburg and played a year.
Okay. All right.
And then he decided that he would switch his major to criminal justice, and now he's a West Des Moines police officer. So
oh, boy. So he's protecting us.
Yeah, he is. That's right.
He's protecting you.
He still is protecting me.
That's good. All right, you're a multi-sport person. Tell us the sports that you were out for.
I played basketball, volleyball. I ran track. I played golf. And I played softball. So two of my years in high school, I played golf and I ran track, and then the other years I just did one or the other.
What benefits do you think you gain from being out for all sports?
It's immeasurable. The time that you get to spend around different people, because in small town a lot of us went out for the same sports, but it still was a different roster. Mm-hmm. Playing for different coaches, different expectations, different seasons. You know, at the end of each season, I loved every sport I played. I couldn't get enough of it. But at the end of the season, I was ready for change. And, you know, even though softball bumped right up to the end of July and volleyball started after that, even though we went from one to the next, it still was a different sport. You're still around a few different people. You had a different coach. And I just think that change helped mentally to adapt to what you're doing. You didn't get as burned out. And I think physically, by using the different muscles and not overusing them, and I just think it made me more well-rounded as well, because in some sports you're great, other sports you might not be as great. Mm-hmm. You know, you just had different roles, and so I think it helped a lot mentally and physically.
Well, and there's probably, even though there was probably a core group that went out, there's probably other people that you would have not maybe had contact with had you not been out for those sports to interact with those people.
Yeah, we did. Like, you know, we're friends with everybody, but you know, during certain seasons, you just spent more time with certain people, and you got to know them, and you got to know underclassmen or the seniors, whatever it was, that went out for those sports, maybe. So it did help with relationships, and it really, the sports not only help you physically, mentally, but socially, just being able to be around other people, meet other people from other schools. I mean, I think that was so important, because, you know, we had the reputation of we were good, but sometimes people thought, oh, you know, those Hubbard Radcliffe girls, they're snotty or stuck up. Well, we weren't at all.
Right.
But from their experience of playing against us, and then we'd meet them, you know, at a track meet, and we'd be sitting talking to them like, oh, my gosh, you guys are a riot. You're so fun.
So you're different off the court than what you
are.
Well,
yeah, or they just got to know us, and they thought, oh, well, you guys are so competitive. It's like, well, yeah, we want to win.
Right.
Who doesn't?
Right,
but
right.
Then they would meet us, and, you know, then some of them became lifelong friends as well.
Well, I think even later in life, like we had conversation over there, and just the people, I mean, I'm a lot older than you are, but just the people that we know, and I just know athletics have maybe given me opportunities I wouldn't have had otherwise, and just the different people that I've met throughout my competitive years and even in my adult years.
Absolutely. And the people cross paths with when I joined the Girls Athletic Union, I had officials that came up to me and said, oh, I officiated your games. I'm like, oh, how did that go?
it was kind of
a firecracker. They're like, oh, no, it was fine. But, yeah, just the past officials, you know, and seeing there's still some school administrators that were around when I was in high school or around that era. And so it is neat to form other bonds with these people that I had contact with when I was in high school.
Okay, this is leading me to, we look at today's athletes. Mm-hmm. And when I had Lacey Corkin-Fulton on, which you're friends with, and she was just like you. She didn't quite do as many sports, but she did, you know, she was busy all year round, and she's a firm believer, and she's a volleyball coach now, that they need to be out for more than one sport. So we've seen a shift where there's a lot of specialization. How do you think that plays in, and what do you see some downsides to a person doing that?
Well, we talked about the physical and the mental side of it. With, I think it also, it just creates so many opportunities for burnout. A lot of these kids are specializing, you know, when they're fourth, fifth, sixth grade. Yeah. And that's great. You know, if you find something you like, there are kids. I mean, they are one sport people, and that's what they want to do. They want to devote all year long to that. But what we found is that, you know, as they get into their, you know, late junior high, early high school years, or even at the end of their high school years, they're burnt out of that sport and they're done with it. You know, like golf is a great lifelong sport.
Right.
You play it all the time. You get burnt out of it. You know, that's a sport that you could play into your 80s, 90s, you know, till 100, whatever you want to do. So I think that the problem with some of the specialization, not all of it. You know, I'm not saying it's a bad thing,
right,
but
right.
I think that sometimes they get stuck in a rut and they don't get to experience some of those other
right.
things. I know a lot of kids will say that maybe they've done a club all through high school and then they'll go out their senior year for their school team.
Right.
And the thing they most say is, I wish I would have done this sooner, because it is a different experience. And, you know, you're playing for your community and your town rather than a group of kids that, you know, the only common thing they have is the sport and the name on their front of their jersey.
Right, right.
So I think that lifelong friendship, relationship, and playing for your community is something that is really something that I still cherish. When I talk about my hometown, people say, oh, Hubbard Radcliffe. And, you know, they probably don't know Hubbard or Radcliffe because of, you know, the color of the corn we have or the streets. They know because
you
want to
play
sport.
And you want a state title. You know, that's just like I had a conversation with a young lady the other day who is going to quit playing one sport and specialize in another. And I'm like, you know, ultimately it's your decision. But, you know, if you think by specializing is going to get you a college scholarship, you have to think about there's going to be people in the gym no matter what. People
mm-hmm.
are going to see you. And I think sometimes maybe there's too much of an emphasis put on, well, if I play club, if I play...
Yeah.
You know, in the summertime, I'm going to have these opportunities.
That scholarship that people keep driving themselves
right,
for.
Right.
I mean, when you talk to college coaches, and you can Google it and you can look it up any
yeah.
way you want, they say multiple sport athletes are what they look for because of the wear and tear,
right.
because of, you know, the ability to be humble, to be awesome, to know their place, you know, just to be able to grow and accept roles. And that's something that they look for because of the growth that those kids have mentally. You know, physically, you can go to the weight room and you can run faster, but you have to be able to accept this and
right,
move on and know
right,
the game. And
right.
and I think that, you know, check with the college coaches because that's
yeah.
what they really want. And these people that do like to specialize, again, you know, there's things where it
right.
is a good idea, but I do think that if you would realize how much time and money and effort you're spending on this sport and then look at the 1% that gets these Division I full ride scholarships,
yeah.
it's a pretty elite group, and it shouldn't overshadow the great benefits of being a high school athlete working for that college scholarship.
And you only go through high school once, and,
yeah.
and like you said, there's some really fond memories and things you'll never forget.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you'll never forget 1993. You'll
never
forget that friend of yours making the last free throw. You know, of the game, she's
yep.
going to remind you that. Just and going back at 25 years, I mean, I'm
yes.
sure that. So if you had one bit of advice to young athletes today, what would it be?
My advice would be to experience it all. So whether you're out for one sport or two sports, you know, go all in. And have fun. Go to the practices. Go to the warm-ups. Enjoy the bus rides. If you're in five sports, do the same. If you're in one sport, but really just love what you're doing. When I talk to women about their high school careers, you know what they talk to me about? They talk about the bus rides. They talk about their teammates. They talk about the locker rooms, the restaurants they stopped at. You know, there's very seldom. They remember the big wins. Don't get me wrong.
Right, right.
When I talk to men about their high school experience, a lot of it revolves around stats, wins, losses. You know, not that that's bad either, but it's just for girls,
it's different.
We have a lot of memories that we remember the details about other things. And I think that's what's made it very special is the bonds that we've had. And I would tell the kids, don't miss out on those wonderful times.
Well, Lisa, thank you for being our guest tonight. And you had some great things to say. And good luck in 2 weeks when the state
yes,
tournament rolls around.
Yes, hopefully we got our snowstorms out of the way
yes,
so we
yes.
can just focus on basketball
okay.
for the state tournament.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Moms typically get to make a majority of the healthcare decisions for their family. That can be a lot of pressure, but not for me, because I know the choice is ours. For medical tests like MRIs, x-rays, CAT scans, and of course mammograms, ask your doctor to refer you to Iowa Radiology. They work around our hectic schedules, they're the best at what they do, and they're so great with my family. They truly care, and it shows. Visit iowaradiology.com or call to schedule an appointment. Iowa Radiology, our focus is your good health.
To get the work done all in one place, G&L Clothing is your hometown Iowa store. Stop in and see us, or we're only a click or phone call away. Family owned for nearly a century, G&L Clothing, 1801 Ingersoll, Des Moines.
G&L Clothing.
MidAmerican Energy and you, together partnering to change the energy landscape by pioneering money-saving, energy efficiency programs and building a new industry in Iowa, wind energy, all while keeping your rates low. So what's next? We'll keep delivering cost-effective energy efficiency programs while putting money back in your pocket. That's right. You decide how best to spend your savings. That's a partnership good for you, good for the environment, and good for Iowa. Another way we're obsessively, relentlessly at your service.
Welcome back to CIS, and I am Flynn Heald, and we are here at Thunderhead Sports Bar and Grill, where the food smells fantastic. I am here today sitting down talking with Jake Remsburg, 4A All-State football player, Iowa State football commit, and all-around incredible person. Jake, thanks for coming.
Thanks for having me.
Hey, so, you know, after a stellar high school career, you obviously now get a chance to reflect on the career. Committed to Iowa State. What were some of those best memories playing high school football at Valley?
Well, obviously you have, like, the on-field memories, like the comeback against Waukee, being Dowling for the first time, didn't get in the second time, but those are two big highlights. I mean, but really the off-field memories is really what I feel like I'm going to remember the most. I mean, I remember all of our O-line dinners, our O-line movie sessions that we had, and it was just a good career. It was a blast.
And I know you guys did those, you know, Thursday night movies. Yep. I that will probably be another part of, of the process you'll miss as well.
Absolutely.
So, you know, it's a beautiful part. It's a beautiful phase. You know, you're moving on from one thing and stepping forward to the next part of your career. So you were an Iowa State commit pretty early. You were an early signing.
Yep.
What was it about Iowa State that you just knew this is the right place for me? I'm committing.
Yeah, just the people and the coaches and everything there is just first class. I mean, it didn't get any better than that. I mean, I'd go to schools and I'd say, is this better than Iowa State? And really none of them were. So I just knew that was the place for me.
So you are one of three offensive linemen from Valley within, and I only dated back to 2010.
Yep.
So, you know, John Raritan at Nebraska, Jake Campos at Iowa State. So you're carrying on an awesome tradition. What does that mean for you, and how are you going to represent your school and that success coming here at the next level?
I mean, it means a lot coming from a school like Valley where you have those type of offensive linemen, and really just credit to our coaches. I mean, our coaches at Valley are great. I mean, Coach Cochran is retired now, but he coached me up to my junior season. He's great. Coach Scott, Coach Mack, I mean, they know what they're talking about, and they'll get you ready for the next level. So you really just got to trust them. And now that I'm heading off to the next level, I feel confident in going to the next level, knowing that I've come from a program where we produce that type of talent.
And it's been a consistent thing.
Exactly.
It's not just, you know, a recent coming. Uh-huh. So props to the coaching staff at Valley High School for that. So looking at this incoming class at Iowa State, there's three kids from the state. There is, you know, yourself, there's Darian Porter of Bettendorf, Cole Flansburg of Solon. How much contact, if any, have you had with those guys and then the rest of your recruiting class?
Our recruiting class has a lot of contact. I mean, we have a Snapchat group chat that we're always like snapping.
That's
on.
Where the kids are these days.
Yep, Snapchat. And so, like, we'll ask each other, like, do you want to play Xbox? Want to hop on Xbox or something like that? And then, but we'll also talk about, like, what we're just expecting for next season, our goals and stuff. So it's a good mix of both those things.
Getting familiar with each other. Yeah, that's
great.
I mean, that's you got to do that before you step foot on campus. So, you know, I really wanted to talk to you about this because offensive line isn't one of those positions where, you know, just your everyday football fan is going to really appreciate what you do in the trenches. You know, the hand placement, you know, where your foot's stepping, being violent at the point of attack, so on and so forth. You don't score the touchdowns. You don't get all, you know, the names and the stats in the paper. To the everyday person out there who doesn't really understand it, explain to them why offensive linemen should be more celebrated, in your opinion.
In my opinion, offensive linemen, they do go unnoticed. But as an O-lineman, we take pride in going unnoticed. We take pride in watching our running backs score. Or we take pride in protecting our quarterbacks so we can throw to our wideouts for touchdowns. I mean, just being an offensive lineman, you know that. So you take pride in that. So there's really nothing bad about it in our point of view.
It's a very blue-collar position,
it is,
you
it
would
really
call
is.
It. Yeah, it's you have to be a certain type of person to really succeed in there in the trenches. I have a lot of respect as a former receiver for you guys inside. So, you know, for the listeners at home who may have a football player like you at home, a little athlete, and he's, you know, on the offensive line, what is one thing that maybe that listener can focus on and give to their kid to help them improve their game?
Yeah, so for when I look at my offensive line game, I take it into three components. You have your strength, obviously, you need to be strong. Your mobility, you need to be able to move with your body. And then you also have your skill work. So if you're an offensive lineman, just really work on those three. And just learning to love the game, to be a passionate for the offensive line position. It's just really big.
Really just appreciating the nuances exactly. of your position. So, again, that was strength, mobility, and your skill set, okay? Yeah. Remember that, kids out there, aspiring to be the next Jake Strenberg. Jake, thank you for your time, and best of luck to you in your future
thank in so
football
much.
Endeavors. But before I let you go, you know we got to finish with a little speed round, okay? Oh, yeah. So I'm going to ask you a question.
Yep.
The first thing that comes to your mind, go ahead and shout it out for me, okay? And now this is cooked by your family. The last meal you'd eat.
Steak.
Okay. Favorite game that you played your senior year?
Walkie.
Do you have a protein powder of choice?
No. Max Muscle.
Okay. If you could be the best in the world in any sport other than football, which one would you choose?
Bowling.
Okay. Best rapper alive?
Alive. Let's go with Drake.
TB12 the GOAT?
Yes.
Okay.
Gotta give it to him.
That was sounding like a little question in your voice there. Where will Antonio Brown end up next season for those football fans out there?
Browns.
Okay. Do you have a favorite teacher at Valley? You want to give a special shout out to someone?
Jay Willis, baby.
All right,
John Williams.
There you go. And if you could pie one of your high school coaches in the face, which one would that be?
Adam McElderry, 100%.
All right. There you go. And there you have it, guys. Coming up next on CISN, we will have Dar and Jimmy go ahead and break down this week in the rankings.
February sales event featuring the Silverado sell down at Schottenkirk Chevy Waukee. Up to $12,500 off or 0% for 72 months, up to $6,500 on select new Silverado crew cabs. Up to $11,000 off select new 19 Silverado HD crews. And over $9,000 off select new 19 Silverado 1500 crew LT and RSTs. WaukeeChevy.com. New 19 crews, $16,900. Up to $6,000 off or 0% for 60 plus. Up to $3,000 off new 19 Equinox. Sale ends soon. Schottenkirk Chevy Waukee. WaukeeChevy.com. February.
Welcome back to CISN.TV. This week, I'm Jimmy Olson with Dar Danielson. We are at Thunderhead Sports Bar and Grill in Ankeny on Ore Labor. And again, play of the week. If you have a great play, be sure to share that with us on social media. You can do that on Twitter and Facebook at CISN.TV. And we might just have your play right here next week or the week after.
Can I send in videos of me blowing snow?
That you know that at this point, I think that is going to be a new sport we're going to start reviewing every week.
That is
snow shoveling and snow blowing. We're going to have tournaments on who can do that the best.
Well, quick story: I blew out, and then you know the plow comes by,
right?
And I went to start it again, pull out, and the whole ripcord came out. It broke. Thankfully, it broke on the end. So, but. I kept it running enough to get the furrow blown out, and then I shut it off. My hands are almost too big to get inside there and take the thing off and reset it. But I did. You know, you learn stuff. But.
So now you're going to try and find an electric start that you can add to it or something, the aftermarket?
Next year I'm getting a new one. I already figured that out because it's everything. Last year the belt broke. This year the pole broke. And, you know, but my thing is I'll buy a new one. Maybe I should. New people will love me because I'll buy a new one and then it won't snow all year.
Right.
And it'll sit there and rust in my shed.
Well, that means I can get out and run again in the wintertime. I don't have to worry about ice, so I'll be okay.
It's hard to get out and do, you know, and then when it's that cold, should I go work out? No, I'll stay under the covers. You know? And that's hard. Hard to do at this time of year. I think we all realize that.
Well, you know, one of the things that keeps me inside is because there's ice. And this is a lot of guy to go running. Yeah. I mean, it's already the earthquake when I'm going for my 2 miles. But, I mean, if I were to fall on ice, it would be like Armageddon. And, I mean, it's like goodbye Des Moines if that were to happen.
Then, it's just dangerous, too.
Absolutely. I mean, my dad fell a couple years ago on the ice. And, I mean, you just got to be careful.
It's not quite as bad as I got pictures from like 2007 when the pile in my driveway was this high.
Right.
It's only down here right now. And hopefully, you know.
Well, we'll see what that's going to be by this weekend. So as we're getting ready, like we talked earlier, we've got the girls tournaments happening here in a couple weeks, which you'll be able to see those on CISN.TV. Where are the rankings? Again, these are going to be changing tomorrow. But where are we sitting at right now as we're getting closer?
Right now, heading into the new rankings, Johnston number one, Waukee number two, Southeast Polk number three, and there's been some battles back and forth between those top three in the last.
Yes, there have.
Cedar Falls, 4. Iowa City West is in at number 5. Iowa City High, 6. Pleasant Valley, 7. Valley, 8. Cedar Rapids Prairie at 9. And Ankeny Centennial at number 10. And, of course, Dowling is right in there, you know, hovering around 2. They've got a good team. They could get hot and go on a run. And that's the thing about the tournaments. If you get going, you get the mojo at the right time, and you know, all these teams we've seen throughout the season, we've seen games where teams will beat one team by 20, turn around the next time, the other team beats them.
Right.
Know?
Well, and as we're getting closer, if you've missed any of these games, I mean, most of them have been on CISN.TV, so go back, rewatch those as you're preparing for the tournament.
Yeah, if you want to see you know, what the teams are like, then you can go do that. So
absolutely.
On the boys' side, can
yes.
we do that now? North Scott, number 1, and I think they're still the only undefeated 4A team mm-hmm. in the state, unless they lost. I didn't see it. But Waukee, number 2. Davenport Central, number 3. Bettendorf, number 4. Iowa City West, number 5. Sioux City East, number 6. Cedar Falls, number 7. Ames, number 8. Valley, number 9. And Dubuque Senior, number 10. And I mentioned earlier in the broadcast, but if you want to see a wacky, crazy game, watch that Waukee at Valley game. Well, either one of them this mm-hmm. year. They both ended the same way. Happy for Waukee fans because they won by a point at both of them at the end, where it went on a string where Valley got ahead, Waukee came back, Valley got it, and then Waukee came back. You know, so a couple wild games there. And North Scott, haven't had a chance to see them, obviously, because they're on the, you know, over in Eastern Iowa, but there's some good talented teams here, you know. North mm-hmm. has been playing well. Hoover's always got a, you know, in there. So there's Ames. You know, there's a lot of teams that the boys' side could be, we talked about, make that run too.
Right, absolutely. So, again, if any games you want to check out, if you've not seen them, go check them out at CISN.TV. If you've not subscribed to our YouTube channel, be sure to subscribe to that. Then you can always get the notification when we go live.
And what I like to do is I call them up on my big screen TV there and watch them, you know, mm-hmm. and take notes about, did my color person talk too much and not let me talk? You know, stuff like that. Oh, wait, no, I mean. But, no, look into that. It's kind of nice. You get a different perspective. It's almost like you're – and you can do that when you're watching them live, too, if you have mm-hmm. to, you know, call them up on YouTube on the big TV and have a party if you can't make it out to the game. And
well, and a lot of times, even at the games that we've been, I mean, people are at the game watching it on there, too. So, I mean, pretty much anywhere, because you can download the app, have it on your mobile device, and watch it anywhere that you are going to be. So.
And I have been surprised in just being out at times in different areas where somebody – we're going to see it. See, I said, no, are you guys the ones that do the volleyball and the basketball and girls? And I said, yeah. And they, oh, well, we appreciate doing that. So, I, you know, it's always nice to hear that people like watching it. And, you know, some of these kids, maybe their first time to state, and some of them have been there a lot of times, but it's always a cool thing when they get there.
Absolutely. Again, if you've got a play of the week that you see, share that with us on social media, on Facebook and Twitter at CISN.TV. Hang on, Javier Toole, he's going to be chatting with Wade Looking Bill. So that's coming up next. And you know what? A lot of great games still yet to come. So again, subscribe to us on our YouTube channel so you can always be notified when we go live. From Thunderhead Sports Bar and Grill on Ore Labor in Ankeny, for Dar Danielson, I'm Jimmy Olson on CISN.TV this week.
Here, head coach of Westside Auto Pros. When your car's on the injured reserve, you want to get it back in the game as soon as possible. I know that. That's why you need to bring it here to Westside Auto Pros. I have a team of experts that can fix almost every automotive injury, whether it's a fractured joint, a brake, or if your car just got its bell rung, no problem. We can even do a complete physical on your car to make sure it's game ready for the entire season. So bring your car to Westside Auto Pros and we'll get it back in the starting lineup in no time. Hey, you guys are dogging it back here. Let's move it, move it, move it.
Nothing's better than a warm fire on a cold day. Hi, I'm Chris from Fireplace Superstore. You may have noticed it's starting to get cold outside, and if you're like a lot of folks, that old fireplace in your house isn't doing you much good. You need to replace that thing with a high-efficient gas fireplace from Heat & Glow. We're going to come in, take your old wood or gas fireplace out. We're going to replace it with a warm, cozy, high-efficient, easy-to-use fireplace from Heat & Glow. It'll be the best thing you ever did to your house. Come see us today.
Because nothing's better than a warm fire on a cold day.
Hi,
it's Javier Toole with CISN.TV, and today we're on location with Wade Looking Bill,
former Iowa Hawkeye, and we're here today to kind of discuss a little bit about basketball, high school sports, and what it takes to be a well-rounded athlete. But let's just get right into it. It's basketball season right now, and in Iowa, we're having a great, I guess, basketball season with girls basketball. Drake, Iowa, and Iowa State are all doing well. And men's basketball, I see that Iowa State's doing great, and so are the Iowa Hawkeyes. So let's just talk about your experience right off the bat, about your Iowa experience graduating from Fort Dodge and then heading over to Iowa City to play for the Iowa Hawkeyes.
Well, first off, Javier, thanks for having me on your show. Yes. I really appreciate it. I always like the opportunity to talk about basketball and young people, so thanks for doing that. But you're right, this is my favorite time of year.
Yes.
Is, you know, no offense to football in the NFL, but that's over, and, you know, it's 10 degrees below zero outside, so everybody's watching basketball. But you're right, both Iowa and Iowa State men, men and women, are having great seasons. The Drake men and women are terrific, and UNI's fighting. They're playing better. So it's a good time in the state of Iowa to be a basketball fan. But I grew up in Fort Dodge, Iowa, graduated in 1988.
So that's kind of my neck of the woods over there, northwest Iowa.
Yeah.
So Fort Dodge was our big location, so I do know the town pretty well.
Yeah.
So I just, sorry for butting in on that.
Yeah,
that
no
was
worries.
Our mecca location to buy shoes.
Did you go to Sports Afoot?
Yes, that's
Yep, my buddy's dad ran that. It's a good part of the state, that northwest Iowa. You know, just a lot of good, I think, well-rounded kids, athletes. They do well in the classroom, and just a lot of tough kids up that area. It's fun.
Yes.
Yeah, absolutely. So graduated in 1988 and was fortunate enough to be named Mr. Basketball that year, a long time ago. But we had a good high school team, had some really good players, and ended up winning the state championship that year for the big school class. And Iowa offered me a basketball scholarship, and I took it, and it was
so
awesome.
That was about 1988, right?
Yep.
So in 1988, you were one of the best basketball players in Iowa. Matter of fact, you're one of the 50 top all-time Iowa basketball players from the Des Moines Register that came out in 2018.
Yeah.
So congratulations on
thanks.
That.
Thanks.
So you're kind of a small-town kid heading to Iowa with Dr. Tom Davis. Maybe, what, third year when you got there?
I think so. Yep. He had two really good years. Made the Elite Eight. That first year went 30-5. And the second year, they even made the Sweet 16.
Yep.
And so I was coming in that next year.
And your guys' class that you came into was pretty good. You guys had a lot of great players. Can you talk about a little bit?
Yeah, we really did. So there were five kids that came in that fall of 88. A.C. Earl was a big man out of Moline, ended up being a first-round draft pick by the Celtics. James Moses was from Carson, California, really good two-guard, really good player, could really shoot it. Ray Thompson, who was another two-guard. Ray was out of Chicago, and he was McDonald's All-American. He was one of the top 20, 25 players in the country that year.
Sense.
And then Troy Skinner, local kid from Palmer, Northwest Iowa.
Yeah,
good friend of mine. Absolutely.
Yep.
And then myself. So we had kind of a unique mix. Had a couple small-town Iowa kids and a kid from L.A., a kid from Chicago, and one from the Quad Cities. So it was a nice mix. It was a fun time.
So when you come in after, you know, seeing the team that Iowa had, did you guys feel a little bit of pressure coming in to, like, keep that going here in Iowa?
A little bit. You know, I looked at it as more, it's just going to be a good experience for me, because the senior class when I was a freshman was Roy Marble, BJ Armstrong, and Ed Horton.
Yes.
And we also had Matt Bullard, who's a 10-year pro. So we didn't need a lot of guys to score. We had plenty of scoring. We just needed guys to do the little things. And that's kind of what I was good at, is just playing defense, being a team player. And I was just excited to be kind of part of that team. I wasn't so much an Iowa fan growing up. It wasn't like I was – it was different back then. You know, it just – there was none of this social media, and there were games on every once in a while, but it wasn't like it is now. But I just went to Iowa because I felt most comfortable there, and was really a fortunate thing for me.
So this might be a question that you may not want to answer, but were you more of an Iowa State fan at that time?
You know, I just liked basketball. I mean, right. I think at that time people kind of forget – because games are on now every night of the week. But back then, it just was the Iowa Television Network in the state of Iowa. So pretty much the only games that were telecast were the Iowa games. So again, when it's 20 below outside on a Thursday, mid-February, not a lot going on. You're going to watch TV. And this was in the infancy of ESPN, so there wasn't all those games. So Iowa was on TV. So that's kind of what you watched, whether you were a fan or not. So that's who I followed growing up. But it wasn't like I had one Iowa jacket, I remember, but other than that, it just was, I like basketball. It's kind of,
So we're in the heart of the NCAA season, and I was just doing some homework on you today, just because I like to make sure I know what I'm talking about, but you were part of some NCAA basketball participation going on. What does it feel like when March Madness comes and you get to play in some of those big games?
It was awesome. It was really neat. So three out of the 4 years I played at Iowa, we made the tournament. Well, my sophomore year, we weren't very good. We actually were ranked maybe 17th at one time, but we lost some kids for grades, a couple injuries, and we ended up not making anything in postseason. But three out of the 4 years, we made the tournament. Always won our first round game, and we always lost our second round game. So we never got past that. In that Sweet 16, that second weekend, which still, even today,
so I want to bring this up. The second round game that you guys lost two times, right, probably was, there's a good reason for it. Do you want to explain the reason?
Well, yeah. So my freshman year, we were a 4 seed and got beat by NC State in double overtime. So could have gone either way. And then my junior year, we ran into Duke in the second round of the tournament. They were really good. They had they were going to end up winning it that year. Or I think they'd won it the year before, and they were going to win it that year. But they were really good. And we were down, I think, 15 at half, and maybe cut it to 5 or 6, but lost by 12.
Yep.
And then my senior year, we lost by about 4 or 5 to Wake Forest. Okay. So close games besides the Duke game. But I always thought that if we could have got to that next weekend, Tom Davis was such a good coach and such a good so good with strategy. That I've thought, boy, if he could have had 4 or 5 days to prepare, that we really could have done some damage. But we just could not get past that second round game.
Yeah, it's kind of amazing, and it's kind of amazing for me to even actually having this conversation with you, because I got to watch you on TV. You know, it was Thursday nights that I was watching, but to be able to meet somebody who's probably played with caliber of basketball players, like playing against Duke, they probably had some guys that were pretty good at that point in time. You know, going against some great coaches.
Fab Five, that's when they were in school and played against those guys
a little bit. So you got to play against Michigan.
Yeah. It was fun. It was really fortunate.
So when you're on the court in situations like that, you know, you're not playing in Fort Dodge, you know, for the state champion. How do you up your game and get yourself ready for that situation?
You know, it sounds strange, but it's still basketball. Yep. You know, the court's a little bigger and there's, you know, quite a few more people in the stands, but it's still basketball. So when you're on the floor, I think even players today, you know, I was playing at Indiana tonight. They're not really listening to the radio or following things, social media. They're just getting ready to play a basketball game. It just happens to be on national TV in front of 17,000 people, but you still got to, you know, play the game. And I think that's kind of looking back, that's what I thought. And I think it's the mindset you have to have. Because if you get caught up in everything, and it's much harder now than it was when I was playing, but it's still just a basketball game.
So let's talk about the Iowa Hawkeyes today. You probably follow them pretty closely.
Absolutely.
What do you think about the team that's going on right now?
I think they're playing pretty well. You know, it's something where it's been 20 years of kind of up and down. They've had a couple good runs, and Coach McCaffrey's been great. He's been terrific with me and with the ex-players. And, you know, I can't always say that with previous staffs, but he's been unbelievable, especially with things like keeping the Chris Street memory alive. He goes above and beyond to keep that memory active. And I think he's really turned the corner with recruiting. You know, this year's senior class and last year's class weren't the best, but some kids just didn't work out. But if you look at the juniors and the sophomores and the freshmen they have, they're really building. And if they can keep getting better, you know, I think they could be, you know, a win a game or two in the tournament type of team. They just got to do the little things. You know, when you get to that point, everybody's good. You know, when you get to the sweet to final 64 teams or the final 32 teams, everybody's good. Everybody's got good players. But can you turn the ball over 12 times, not 15 times? Or can you, you know, shoot 85% for the line in the game, not 75%? It's just the little things that are going to kind of get you that next win.
So there's a good chance that they could play Iowa State.
I saw that in Des Moines, even maybe, yeah.
Would you probably be at that game if you had the possibility?
Absolutely, absolutely. There's a long ways to go for that to happen. I think both teams got to finish strong. Iowa State's probably got a better chance just with the way that their conference is set up, because they've won some really big games, some road games. I think it'd be great for Des Moines. You know, they can't match them up in that first round. I think there's something where they'd have to meet in that second round. But it's a long way to go, but stranger things have happened.
It'd be great for the state of Iowa for basketball. So here, what we like to talk about, and we're talking to you today because, Wade, you're just a great guy. Overall, you were a great athlete.
Thanks.
And just a great person overall. If you could give some advice to, you know, an athlete, like somebody in Fort Dodge, Iowa, or Shaler, Iowa, out there shooting hoops or getting ready for the season, what would you say to them to say, hey, this is the path that you need to take to make sure that you're successful in the whole aspect of the game?
You know, I think it's just comes down to things you'd even tell your third grader playing basketball is, we're going to work hard, and we're going to get better, we're going to have fun. And other than that, everything's going to work itself out. You know, if you can play, you can play. There's only so much you can do to make yourself a basketball player. Now, if you're a guard, you can work on ball handling and shooting. But again, if your parents are 5'8 and 5'7, you're probably not going to be 6'9. So there's some things that are not always in your favor, but there's places for 5'11 point guards to play, and there's places for 6'5 kids from Fort Dodge, Iowa to play. So I would just, I guess, again, work hard and have fun. And more specific, if I'm 12 years old today, I'm shooting the basketball from three. I think that's where you can really differentiate yourself, no matter if you're 5'10 or 6'10. Because that three-point line, it is the great equalizer at high school, especially at the college level, even the NBA level now. It's such a weapon. And if you can shoot the basketball, there's places for you to play. But I think that's, you know, kind of an ancillary thing. Just have fun. You know, that what are the stats that 1% of all high school basketball players will even play Division I basketball? Yes. It's probably not going to happen for most kids, but you can have a lot of fun in high school. It's playing basketball and being with your friends and traveling and playing multiple sports and being in the band or the chorus or the school play. Do as much as you can, and whatever it is, have fun.
Well, Wade, I want to thank you for giving us the opportunity to come into your home, talk to you a little bit about Iowa basketball, the NCAA, and just what it takes to be a well-rounded person. So I want to thank you again for the opportunity. We're going to have to say, go Hawkeyes.
Absolutely.
And thank you.
Thanks, Javier. For any time, man. I appreciate it.
This is Javier from CISN.TV. We'll see you guys soon.
Sales event featuring the Silverado sell down at Schottenkirk Chevy Waukee. Up to $12,500 off, or 0% for 72 months, up to $6,500 on select new Silverado crew cabs. Up to $11,000 off select new 19 Silverado HD crews, and over $9,000 off select new 19 Silverado 1500 crew LT and RSTs. WaukeeChevy.com. New 19 crews, $16,900. Up to $6,000 off, or 0% for 60 plus. Up to $3,000 off new 19 Equinox. Sale ends soon. Schottenkirk Chevy Waukee. WaukeeChevy.com.
Miss your hometown clothing store? The one that had it all? Everything to get the work done all in one place? G&L Clothing is your hometown Iowa store. Stop in and see us, or we're only a click or phone call away. Family owned for nearly a century, G&L Clothing, 1801 Ingersoll, Des Moines. G&L Clothing, your size, your style.